Hello everyone and welcome on De Papier de Rêve channel. I'm Ursula and today I will be painting with you a sketch in my sketchbook. My subject today is a building. It's an observatory here in Stockholm. And I think it's a quite an interesting subject because the shape is interesting. And I like this look a bit old of a building. Today I haven't cut my sketch from the video, so you are able to see it, and I wanted you to see it because I think it's quite interesting to see how much I sketch before I paint, and that's very little in fact. And I'm not sketching too much just because I want to focus on the painting, and I don't think I'm very good at sketching. In fact, there is quite a lot of mistakes in perspective in this one, but I don't care because I want to focus on the painting and the expression I will put in it. So if my sketch is a bit wonky, I'm okay with that. And in order to get this expressive content, I will use a lot of supplies here. So starting with my pencil sketch, which you will be able to see it until the end, because I do not erase it after. And I will use also watercolor paint, of course, but also watercolor pencils and something new, I don't know how it's called in English. It's like a square, like a pastel, but watercolor too. And I will also use a little bit of white Posca to get some highlight at the end. And in fact, this painting is not just a painting, it's also an exercise to see what sort of tool I like and I will be enjoying in plein air session. So I really want to make more plein air painting. So I'm testing all my supplies to see what fits to me for this kind of sketch and what I want to do with them. But let's talk about this watercolor. And I'm using right now my watercolor pencil on a wet surface in order to get the most payoff of color on my paper. And I really enjoy using them like that because I think it's the best way to get texture and interesting marks with them. And I'm still very pleased with my selection of colors and in particular with this Caput Mortuum Violet that I'm using right now. In fact, all the colors I've chosen recently are going very well with my habits of mixing colors, and I can use them in lots of sketches. They will go well with my way of painting, in fact. So like I said at the beginning, there is quite a lot of mistakes in my perspective, in my drawing, because I'm not very good at drawing in perspective. I found it very hard, and I really prefer to focus on putting color on my papers and expressing myself on the paper, and the drawing part is not that important for me. And maybe some of you will be mad at me because I'm drawing so badly, but I'm sorry, I don't care. I'm just drawing my way and enjoying myself painting a sketch, very messy, and that's what I like. And I really enjoy myself when I'm mixing colors and when I'm creating texture, when I put some brush mark on my paper. And I don't want to stop painting just because I'm not good at drawing. I think it's not fair. And I just can't express myself with colors. And if my sketch is not quite right, well, maybe it's not the most important part of my painting. And I think as a beginner, it's quite important to keep in mind that you don't need to know how to draw accurately to have fun painting. You can still enjoy yourself by creating art with just what you got in your mind. And drawing isn't maybe the most important things to get for painting. And in today's sketches, I'm very pleased how it's turning. I think there is quite a real expression in here, and I'm very happy with this painting overall. I like the colors and the texture I'm getting on my paper, and I think they are quite in adequation with what I've been able to see when I take the picture of this building. And now let's talk about supplies. For the brush, I've used only one brush, the Raphael Petit Gris 803 number 2. And for the color, I've used Indentrain Blue, Verona Gold Ochre, Kinacridone Gold, Kinacridone Burnt Scarlet and Burnt Sienna. And I've also used a lot of small tools like white Posca pen, this square watercolor bar from Winsor & Newton in cobalt turquoise, and some watercolor pencil in Caput Mortuum Violet, Earth Green and Chromium Green Opaque. And my paper is from Saunders Waterford, and you can see the watermark in the bottom of my painting. And I've mounted it in a sketchbook, which I've bind myself. And this paper is quite thin compared to what I'm used to. It's only 180 GSM. But it's quite a nice paper, and it can hold a lot of water. It will buckle, of course, but with the clip I have on my sketchbook, it's just okay, and it doesn't buckle too much. With sketches, I think that's a perfect paper for sketches, because when you sketch, you do not use as much water as in other painting, and so the buckle is not quite a problem in sketches. Meanwhile, I have added some sky to my painting, and it's the perfect addition to bring all of my painting alive. I've used Indentrain Blue for the sky, but I haven't rinsed well my brush, so I think there was a little bit of burnt sienna on it, and my sky turned a little bit grey, but I'm totally okay with that. I think it's it has a more natural looking this way, and I think it's look fine. And this hint of sky will balance the painting quite a lot, because all the color I've used on the building is warm color, and the fact to have a little bit of cool color just on the side makes the painting more balanced, and it brings more light to the building. And now I'm just adding some details here and there with my watercolor pencil, and a bit later with my white Posca pen. It will help to bring some white area back in the painting, and makes things a little bit more alive too. And my painting is mostly finished, and I'm very happy with it, and I think there is a great texture in it, and yeah, I like it. And this video is now ending. Thanks for watching. I hope you like it. Please check the blog post for more information about it, and tell me what you think in the comments. See you soon.